Good morning, children. Welcome to our English class. Today we are going to continue from our past class. In our last class, I explained to you about simple past and simple present and simple past. And before that, I told you that we should know very well about, because we in the structures, in the tenses, in the structures, we are using verb forms V1, V2. So you should know specifically what is V1 form of the verb and V2 form of the verb. Now today I'm going to give you few more examples of the verb forms other than those that I have given you from the last time, and also we'll give you the whole table for the structures of the tenses. And this will not end with this one class, children. Tenses means it is very interesting, and you have to have lot of practice. You have to do many more examples in it. That is why I'm stressing on it. We have taken last week, this week, and obviously we will take another day in the week as well. Now if you see here, I'm going to give you more. So I wrote here present, past and past participle. These are nothing but V1, V2 and V3 form of the verbs. Okay, so there are few verbs that change when it is in present tense. It is in one word, it is in different way. In past tense it changes, and in past participle it changes into a different word. So these are few. I think it's important for you to note down. Go, went, gone. So here all the words have changed in each different term. Now, write, wrote, written. Next one. Teach, taught. Shut, shut, shut. So here they do not change. If you notice here, put, 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 shut, 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 cut, cut, cut. They do not change in any form of the verbs. Find, find. Find. Cry, cried, cried. Okay, so these are few words that for you to notice and to understand. I do have like about maybe more than 100 words. I have more than 100 words with me. This is, and these words I learned them from probably when I was in schooling. So I have about more than 100 words. If you want, I can send the pictures of these and then we can continue with the lesson. So I don't have to write all of them on the board, and it's a waste of time, right? So if we go through the tenses, that will be much more easier. So here you can pause it and make a note of them. If not, it is still fine. I'm going to send you the pictures. So now what we'll do is we'll go for tenses. Okay. Now I'm going to write them. So I'll leave the present, past. We don't need past participle here. Write. present and past here. Okay. Now we are talking about tenses. Verb forms, I will send you a lot of them. I will send you about 3-4 pictures of those words. So it will be easy for you to learn. So now let's have a recap of our tenses. What did I say in the last time? We have structures for every tense. And those structures are very important. And I also told you that I will give you the definition. Okay, I'll give you the definition of the tenses. So you can write down. For present tense, I already told you the structure. It is subject plus V1 form of the verb plus object. Simple as it is. Structure is what is important. Now for past tense, what do we have? Subject plus V2 form of the verb plus object. Very simple again. Now we are going to see few more examples for the children. Then we will get into the textbook. See children, now when we are talking about tenses, in present tense itself, in simple present tense itself, there are different kinds of sentences that we use. For example, if we see here, it says I go, or I go means I will go, or Ram goes, so Ram will go. Those are called affirmative sentences. These are types of sentences. There are 5 types of sentences that we learn, right? I hope you learnt in your previous classes, like in your 5th standard. What do you say? What are the types of sentences that you learnt? Affirmative, optative, interrogative, exclamatory, and there is one more. Those are assertive. So 5 types of sentences: affirmative, assertive, interrogative, exclamatory, and optative. We know these 5 types. If you do not know, I hope you learned them, but if you did not know, then we have time. I can give you a detailed description or a detailed explanation about 5 types of sentences. See, for affirmative sentences, it is like confirming. Now here, this statement, this sentence, Ram goes means it is affirmative. He goes, he will go. And there are negative sentences. I do not go. Negative, right? But these doesn't come under those 5 types of sentences. Affirmative sentences are more like, general sentences. Come in, sit down, all those things. And assertive are more like bossy. When you say shut up, it has to happen right there. It has to happen right then. So those, come in means you have to come in right then, no? You won't come after an hour or so. So that is what we are talking about. Now interrogative means questioning sentences. Why are you there? What are you here? What are you doing here? What's your name? All these things are interrogative. We are questioning sentences. Okay. Exclamation. We already know what are exclamatory sentences. They are emotion. We are talking about sudden emotions like alas, hooray, wow. When we add these sudden emotions, then they come under exclamatory sentences. Then optative sentences are more like blessings. See, when people say they wish your birthday, they say happy birthday, God bless you, and try to curse people, whether they'll happen or not. They'll tend to curse when they do not like them. See, when usually in villages and all, if somebody is growing richer, When they're growing richer, their neighbors are growing richer, the other people will not like it. They don't like it. They keep cursing them in some way or the other. Those like blessings, curses, and all those things come under optative. So those are different types of sentences. Now when we are talking about present tense, simple present tense, simple means it is simple. You don't have to worry about it. It's just you need to have a person to do some action, and that action is the verb, and they have to do some by using something. That will be the object. Subject, verb, object. And in present tense, it is V1 form of the verb. So we have verbs and we have the present form, the past form, and the past participle form of verbs. So here it is quite simple. You don't have to think too much about it. There is so much in depth in English that you have to learn if you want to learn. See, in Telugu also we have like lots of, we speak Telugu normally because it is our native language. We speak it very naturally, and we don't get across any mistakes. Like, unless it is some word to read from the textbooks, you won't have any mistakes while speaking and listening and understanding, because it is our mother tongue and we have been like churned into it. Like it is in our usage from our birth. So what I'm saying is, like, if you want to learn English, and it is not about textbook, it is not about how or the structures or the types and all you have to know is the flow of English, how you can use these sentences and which word is appropriate in which circumstances. So all those are quite important. You do not have to think a lot about it. See, if I go through, like, the simple present means all I can say is subject, V1 form of the verb, and object. If you remember that, and there are certain rules like where we use them and when they come across, that is fine, that should do. Sorry. But here it talks about affirmative, it talks about negative, interrogative. So these are nothing but the normal sentences we use. We use them regularly, but we just don't know that they are called in certain names. You understand, children? It is very simple. All I'm saying is, see, when we are talking, for example, let me explain it to you in Telugu. Telugulo manam maatladetappudu, we use lots of sentences. See, Raju veltadu. So affirmative, that is called affirmative. Raju goes. Simple sentence, kada. Then when we are talking about nen vellanu, I do not want to go, or I don't go, he doesn't go. Then what happens? We are saying a negative thing, not a positive one. Then it becomes negative form of the tense. Okay. Next, there is interrogative. Interrogative, I told you, know what is interrogative type? Questioning type. So, does Ram go? Now, questioning. Adugutunnam. Does Ramu veltada? Question, no? So, that is interrogative tense. So in simple tense only, there are everything. So let me write and explain to you. You don't have to remember affirmative, negative, or interrogative. You don't have to remember idi deentloki vastundi, idi affirmative loki vastundi. Manam maatladetappudu avanni maatladtham. Ramu veltada ani adugama, adugutam. Mummy, daddy vastara ani adugutam kada, question, which is an interrogative sentence. So we use them regularly, but we do not know that they are called. They have certain categories. Vaalle aa sentences ni konni categories lo manam pettamani manaki teliyadu. Aa headings manaki teliyadu ante. But we already use the language in Telugu. In the same way, you will learn how to use it in English. I don't want to give you like in deep or anta deep description, explanation is not necessary. So that is why we'll stick to the main structure, few examples, and you will know how and where to use them. But the types of sentences here, you should know. So So that is why I'm giving some examples here. Again, we did few examples last time, so we'll do them again now. Few. I go to school. నేను స్కూల్కి వెళ్తాను. ఓకే, నా సెకండ్ వన్. దిస్ ఈజ్ లైక్ అఫర్మేటివ్, అఫర్మేటివ్ ఫామ్. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్ ఐ డు నాట్ గో. ఐ డు నాట్ గో దేర్. ఆర్ యూ కెన్ యూజ్ ఐ, యూజింగ్ ఐ ఆల్ ది టైమ్. యూ కెన్ యూజ్ Ram does not go or doesn't go. Okay, even here you can use the sentence. Instead of I, we can use simple as it is. Ram goes to school. Okay, now next one. Does Ram go? Question. Does Ram go? Ram veltada? So different types of sentences, but they are in simple present. You are talking about simple present. Okay? Now, there is interrogative, negative. So you can also use does Ram not go? You can ask that also. Okay. Now, these are the sentences, similar kind of sentences using the same. All you have to remember, children, in simple present here is subject. The subject here is Ram. Okay, here Ram is the subject. Ram. Okay. Now, V1 form of the verb means simple. Goes, go, go, go. Simple. No, because what are the verb forms of go? Go, went, gone. Okay? So, V1, V2, V3. Right? So, here we need V1. So, we used go. Goes, go, go, go. All these are verbs here. And school is the object. Here you do not have specifically any object here. We are not talking about it. Doesn't really have to be there. Now, I'll give you another example here. Fifth one. I write means నేను రాస్తాను. ఇప్పుడు రాస్తాను, రేపు రాస్తాను, ఎప్పుడు రాస్తూ ఉంటాను, ఇలా ఏ రాస్తాను. సో ఐ రైట్. నా వి సీ అబౌట్ సింపుల్ పాస్ట్. విల్ ట్రై టు కన్వర్ట్ దీస్ సెంటెన్సెస్ ఓన్లీ ఇన్ టు పాస్ట్ టెన్స్. సో రామ్ గోస్ టు స్కూల్. రాము స్కూల్కి వెళ్తాడు. నా వాట్ డు వి వాంట్. All that you have to remember is subject will remain the same, object will remain the same, and only the verb form will change into V2 form of the verb. So, goes will change into went. Go, went, gone, no? So, we need V2 here. So, what we'll do? Ram went to school using the second one, V2 form. Now, Ram doesn't go. Negative, no? So, we'll also write. So we don't want Ram doesn't go means Ram velladu. Ivelladu repellu tarvata velladu eppudu velladu. It is talking more like about universal actions, no? So what we'll do? Ram doesn't go. All you will do is Ram didn't, doesn't will become didn't go. Okay, I just don't want to confuse you here. If you want, I can give you a different example, right? So we'll see. Easy one. Let's see an easy one. So because I don't want to give you all those affirmative, all those sentences. So if you note these down, this is fine. You will understand because this is an affirmative sentence. This is a negative sentence because we are using doesn't. And here we are using interrogative sentence, and here interrogative negative sentence. So different kinds of sentences, but they all are talking about simple present. I'll give you a few more examples, and then we will go into we'll convert them into both the tenses, children. Now, I'm giving you the definition here for simple present. Definition is it is used when is simple present used? It is used to describe repeated actions. Repeated actions. It is used for repeated actions, habits, or characteristics of things. Characteristics of things. Now, next point is it is also used for universal truths. Universal truths like the sun rises in the east and all those things, okay? Now, it is also used for to express future actions, certain future actions, not for everything, but certain future actions. Okay, so those are the three important points, children. It is used to describe repeated actions, habits, or characteristics of things. And it is also used for universal truths. It is also used to express future actions. Now what I'll do is, we'll look at this later. Now for each rule, we will write an example. Now, what is he saying? It is used to describe repeated actions or habits. What are repeated actions? Let's see. For repeated actions, I am writing example here. Repeated action means that action has to happen every day. Like, I drink coffee every morning. Okay, I drink. I am using a V1 form only. So this is not any continuous tense. I drink coffee every morning, which means I drink it every morning. It happens today, it happens tomorrow, it happened yesterday. So I'm talking about a repeated action. That action will be continued every day. So the first one is I drink coffee every morning. Okay, so he said, what is the definition say? It is used to describe repeated action. So this action, what is this action? Drinking coffee. What I'll do? I'll do it today. Every morning, I'm saying every morning. So how many mornings are there? Every single day there is a morning, no? So I drink coffee every single morning. So that is a repeated action. Roju chese pani. Alavatuga chese pani. Okay? Now. Next, habits. Habits means Geeta sings well. You can use any kind of verb here, children. So, sing, because that is a habit of hers. She likes to sing, so she sings well. Baga paadutundi. Ante. Ivaal paadutundi, rep paadna baga paadutundi, ellun paadna baga paadutundi. So, she sings well. Next, so that is a habit. This is a repeated action. Now let's see characteristics of things. Now, what is a characteristic character of a thing? Characteristics means any specific. We are talking about like adjectives here. We are talking about adjective, which means we are describing something, describing some action of a thing. So, how the performance of that thing is. So, for example, this machine works very fast. So, what is he saying? This machine works very fast. So, the machine works really fast. Okay, so here the definition is satisfied, no? What did it say? Describe, it is simple present is used to describe repeated action. So we have a repeated action. I drink coffee every morning. I take bath every morning. I brush my teeth every morning. So these are repeated actions. Every single day these actions will happen. Next, habits, singing, dancing. So dance well, sing well, anything. You can use any sort of verb. Characteristics of things. Konni vastuvulu chese vaati pani. Describe cheyadaniki simple present use cheyochu. Because any time that machine will work fast only, no? So its performance is being fast. Its characteristic is being fast. Computer calculates really fast, right? So as long as it has that power supply and everything, it will work the same way every day. Not like humans. We get tired. In the morning, we will be fresh, energetic and active. And we will work nicely. By evening, our energy becomes low. Right? But computers don't do that. They work the same way from morning to evening. So, we are describing the performance of a thing. So here we are talking about a machine, and what are we saying? It works fast. It works fast today, it works fast tomorrow, it worked fast yesterday. So any day it will do that action. So that is why this definition is satisfied here. And next, what it says? It is also used for universal truths. Universal truths means that we cannot deny. Ila jaragadu ani evaru cheppaledi. ఖచ్చితంగా అలా జరుగుతుంది కాబట్టి ఎవ్రీ సింగిల్ డే అండ్ యూనివర్సలీ టు ద హోల్ యూనివర్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్ ఇట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ సేమ్ ఇట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ న్యాచురలీ అండ్ నోబడీ కెన్ డినై ఇట్ నోబడీ కెన్ టేక్ అవే ఇట్ ఓకే ఇట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఇన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద హ్యాండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ది నేచర్ నోబడీ కెన్ డినై ఇట్ సో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ 2 plus 2 makes 4. So 2 plus 2 makes 4. What do you say?
Kadantar evarena 2 plus 2 4 antanu.
So can you say no? Can you deny it? Nobody can. Nobody in the world. American evaraina vachi chacha 2 plus 2 4 kaadu ani cheptara? Poni China vallu vachi cheptara? For everybody in the world, for everybody in this universe, 2 plus 2 is 4. It is a universal truth. Nobody can deny it. Nobody can fight against it. Right? So that is what is called a universal truth. Andariki adi same untundi. The sun rises in the east. Even in China it rises in the east. Even in Japan it rises in the east. Any country, anywhere in the world, the sun rises to them in the east, to us in the east. Okay? So that is another universal truth. So here we satisfied this definition, this point of definition, no? So next, it is also used to express future actions. Future action antnam, which means it did not happen. Inka jaragaler. But why are we not calling it future tense? Which means there is a certain explanation to it. Let me tell you. Now, future actions. Our school opens in June. So after summer holidays, every year after summer holidays, when will our school reopen? June 12th, right? Usually. Now because of corona, we do not consider anything. But usually, every year, our school reopens in June. So it is a future action. Year June lo open avutundi. Next year June lo open avutundi. Aa next year academic year manaki eppanuncho kuda June 12th pettukunnam. So it is a future action. It will open. It did not open, but it will open. But we are not saying it will. We are not using will here. Our school is the subject. Opens is the verb, V1 form of the verb. And in June is the object. Got it? In all these sentences also, we have subject, V1, object. I, subject. Coffee, object. Drink, verb. Coffee, object. Okay? Next, Geeta, subject. Sings, verb. Well, object. This machine, subject. Machine is the subject here. Works. Work means pani kada. So verb. V1 form of the verb. Fast is the object. Here we cannot call this object because it is an adjective. 2 plus 2 makes 4. 4 is the object. 2 plus 2 we are talking about the subject. Our school, subject. Opens is an action. In June. So these are the definitions, or this is the set rules for simple present, and I have given you each example that can satisfy all these points in definition. So here we saw repeated action, here we saw habit, here we saw characteristic of a thing, and here we saw universal truth, and here we saw future action. Okay, children? So, our president arrives tomorrow. If we are waiting for our president to come tomorrow, we know, we should not say he will come tomorrow. Because we know for certain that he is going to come tomorrow. Presidents don't change their actions. See, they have a planned schedule. If we want to go somewhere, what we'll think, we'll have an idea now. In the next minute, we will change our plan, and it is not pre-planned. But here we are talking about pre-planned actions, which is our school reopens in June. We know it will definitely open in June, so it opens in June. Our president arrives tomorrow, which means he will come tomorrow. It is a future action. He didn't come yet, but we are talking in simple present. So this is very important, children. Please make a note. This is the definition, the characteristics or the points that you have to remember, and these are examples. And in our next class, we'll finish with simple past as well. And for your homework today, all you have to do is try to write these sentences in simple past using the structure subject plus V2 form of the verb plus object. Okay? So that will be your homework, or shall we complete it now? See, my ideas are changing again. So I will, but I want you to learn by definition. I want to give you some definition and then take you through and give you more examples and all those things. So yeah, we'll do it in our next class, children. And we also touch future tense, and then we'll close it up. We'll wind it up next week. And we'll see how many more lessons are left, so that I want to complete it fast. Not fast, but just finish it off. Because we are taking it too slow recently. Sorry. Now please make a note of this and these. These are very important. Even in our last class, I explained to you simple present and simple past, which are quite easy. And verb forms, I will send you the pictures. So we'll wind up for this class, and this is it. Please practice them, the structures and all those things which are really, really important for you. For now, they are only simple present and simple past, but in future you will have continuous tenses, and which are much more critical. It's okay to learn about continuous tense, but perfect tense, most of you will do mistakes. So learn this very well, and so we'll wind up for today, and this is it. Please make note and keep learning, and try to write these sentences, these five sentences, in past tense, simple past tense, using this structure, which is subject plus V2 form of the verb plus object, which means all you have to do is I drink coffee, and drink will become drank. And I drank coffee every morning. I drank coffee every morning means, which means you're telling about the past. Pradaka pratiroju nen coffee taagenu ani. Geeta, what is the past form of sing? Sang. Geeta sang well. So Geeta paat baga paadindi. So already paadisindi. This machine worked very fast. Worked, no? So 2 plus 2. Makes 4. This is critical. Universal truths are hard to change, because but still you can say 2 plus 2 made 4. Made, no? Now our school opens in June. So when you're talking about past, our school opened in June. Already open aipoyindi. So opened in June. So I already told you the answers. So it is easy for you. Please write these sentences in simple past as well. In our next class, I'll give you the definitions and the same examples. Okay, children? Now, thank you, and keep reading.